Oh, let's just call it the running jackal. Just approaching the 1 kilometer mark in zone 3, I'm imagining. It is early for me. It's about 7:30 in the morning. It's the 6:56 for the first K. So I'm now on crushed gravel. It's been a very good week for podcasts, even though most of them have been a little on the long side. Even my Wednesday show was 4 minutes longer after my initial edit, from over an hour to 44 minutes. And then when I was listening to it, I realized I had 4 minutes of me fumbling with my keys. I took that out for the second version, but the version that's on Stitcher is 44 minutes long. But the problem there was that I had my voice recorder locked in the hold position, which means that when I pressed pause, nothing happened. It just continued to record my feeble attempts to lock up the bike. I had the voice recorder in one hand and my keys in the other, which made it kind of difficult to maneuver the bike. It has one stand at the back, a prop stand, and everywhere I put the bike, the stand was on soft grass, which meant that it was not stable. I just saw 2 people running. I might see them later on the mountain. We'll see a man and a woman. Today I'll be riding the pause button, trying to get a 36-minute continuous file. I should be able to manage it. This run is going to be about an hour, so I have to record just about half of it for you guys. I'll be coming up on the 3K quite shortly. So I'm in zone 4 at the moment. Trying to make the most of the easy stuff. Alright, I'm hiking now, one of my TH sections. There are a couple of hikers up ahead that seem to be doing much what I'm doing, but I don't think they're running the flats, So I should catch up with him around the 3. Jogger coming through. Hi. Good morning. Back in zone 4. Just saw a bunny. Another TH section coming up. Just here, I hike again. And I'm running again. That was about 40 seconds of pause while I hiked up the steep section. It's going to be pretty undulating until I get to the resort. Another hike. .138 is my heart rate average. And I think my pace was 738 per kilometer. So I still have a little bit of a cushion for my 8-minute overall average. If I come off the mountain around 8:40, I should be able to make it up, because the rest of the run back to Mount Doug Food Market is pretty flat. So this is the resort corner. This is where I take a sharp turn to the left and head into the quiet zone. I shall get back to you when I'm on the fake bridges. Actually, I just remembered I'm not going over the fake bridges today. I'm taking the perimeter trail. I'm in zone 3 now, chugging along at 7.5 minute kilometers. A little bit short of breath today. Too much caffeine this morning. This is real ankle-busting stuff here, so I'm very cautious about running with abandon here. But this section now is a little bit clearer. What tends to happen is the vegetation on either side of the trail starts to grow vigorously and block the view. So you have to pretty much guess where your feet are stopping. Hello. Hello, dog. Oh, she surprised me. Came out of nowhere. Today, my lovely wife, Norma, is playing pickleball with her friends at, where is it now, McMinn Park, just off the Lochside Trail. She's taking her e-bike. But they start today at 8:30, so I should be heading off pretty soon. She likes to have some breakfast before she goes out. I spared myself that luxury. I ate quite a lot yesterday, which probably will see me through till noon today. By which time, most of the runners in the Western State 100-mile endurance run will have finished. I believe they have until 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon to make the cut, which must be tragic for those who come in 31 hours, because I believe they only have 30 hours to complete. But that person who comes in on 29 hours 59 minutes gets essentially exactly the same buckle as the person who wins the event. So the only difference is that in that particular event, if you finish in under 24 hours, the buckle will have a gold logo in the middle. I think it's a mountain lion, I'm not sure. I've just been reminded that I'm in zone 3 and I'm hiking, so the effort level is still quite high. Now I'm within inches of a barbed wire fence. So there's no mud in this section, which is great. Normally, I avoid this section for most of the year because, as my friend Dan would call it, he would say, are we going through the muddy section? So he always used to call this one the muddy section. But not today. Today it's just dry dirt. I forgot my sunglasses this morning, so hopefully I'll be staying under the canopy most of this run. And by the time I pop out again, I'll be in my neighborhood running towards home. I will finish my run at the food market, because I only need, I think it's 1 hour and 6 minutes to make up my 10 hours of training this week. I know 2 hours of it was e-bike, but I did manage to stay on target for my heart rate. I think I stayed in zone 2 most of that 2 hours of riding, which It's the same effort that I am doing now with my hiking and running. Pretty soon the elevation will kick in and I will be reduced by that to a slightly less exciting pace. But really and truly, it'll be exciting enough for sure. I didn't bring my camera today, so I apologize for that. I won't be taking any pictures today. But if you've noticed from my posts this week, I have been basically paying homage, or as the French would say, homage. I've been paying homage to Mount Doug. I have seen it from three different angles. $7.53 per kilometer, and I'm halfway through my run. Still not at the summit yet, but I am going through the saddle, so I will never hit the actual summit. I will hit my high spot for today. Jim and Anthony recorded on Wednesday because I believe that Mr. McCann has family business this weekend. Visitors, blood relatives. So they recorded their 2-hour extravaganza on Wednesday. And then lo and behold, Jimmy comes up with a show on Saturday. So between them, they have entertained me for almost 3 hours over the past couple of days. Now, granted, I don't have a life, so that's not too much of a concern. But I believe there should be some consideration made to brevity. I have to watch out now. There's a trail to the left that I might miss today with the overgrown conditions, but once I'm on that trail, I will be heading along Upper Whittaker towards Glendenning and my eventual exit of the park. So within a few minutes I will be on the down slopes, which will be nice. Still not really hot, but I am perspiring a fair bit now from effort. Just coming up on my little shortcut to Upper Whittaker. Here we go. I have to remember to pick up the voice recorder above the branches of the bushes on either side. Otherwise, you'll be hearing a lot of noise as the leaves and twigs clip the recorder. Almost clear of this steep section. I could see the trail ahead. Ow. Ow. I just walked through a branch that I thought was going to offer very little resistance, but in fact, it scraped me. Nothing serious, just Just a flesh wound, as they say. No blood. No blood. Almost through this next ankle-busting section. Zone 2 is my heart rate, and I'm barely moving. Whereas zone 2 on my e-bike, and I'm going along at 25 kilometers an hour. It's a very efficient way of covering large distances. Not exactly effortless. It could be effortless, but I don't ride the throttle, if you know what I mean. Take a left, head for the saddle. Just coming up on the highest point today. As I go through the saddle, through the jaws of the saddle, two large monoliths on either side. So now it's Whittaker down, then Glendenning down, and then Beaupark up, and then finish. I'm going to be buying a fair amount of stuff today, so I don't have to go out again. I definitely need to buy some more potatoes. That's cheap wherever you go. Mount Douglas Market is a convenience food store. It's not the economy supermarket, but for items like potatoes, you might be paying a little over the odds, but they're still fairly cheap. I hear voices. Yeah, they're the two hikers I passed earlier. They're going a different way from me today as I pass the Cougar Cave. Hello again. Yep, they were going up and I'm going down. There's a side trail that skirts the upper shoulder of Mount Douglas, the Mountain of Joy. So I think that this episode will intrigue you with its title. I'm going to call it Homage to the Mountain of Joy. Having explained that all my runs this week have been looking at the mountain from various vantage points. Excuse me. Below zone, but that's because I'm heading downhill. So 8:55 now that I'm heading down. Zone 3 heading down, so I have picked up a fair amount of speed in the last few seconds. As I approach the glory zone, two hiking friends will probably appear just behind me to the left. They took the slightly shorter but slightly steeper up section. So right as I hit the glory zone, I will pause this recording until a fair bit later. I have done 5 of 8, so I have 3 more kilometers. This is the fastest section for me today. Probably doing about 6 minute kilometers right now, downhill slightly. Zone 3. Hello, good dog. Hi. My heart is enjoying this little downhill after all that climbing earlier on. It always has this whoopee moment when we start on the downside. I'm still pushing zone 3 though, which is, I would like 132, I think. 133. As I head onto the bridle trail that runs parallel to Glendenning Road. .827 average so far today. So it's coming down from 9 in the last K. I have knocked half a minute off my average pace. As I cross Mount Douglas Crossroad, heading towards Moulton Road and Beaupark, eventually I will be running through Beaupark. All morning I've been seeing arrows in chalk marked on the road. Somebody was out here either yesterday or is out here today following a predetermined route. Yep, the arrows are all pointing towards me. So, they're going anti-clockwise today. And I'm going uncle clockwise. I got that from Jim yesterday, I think. The anti-clockwise. He's my official Brit spotter. He picks me up on dialogue that is traditionally British, not necessarily Canadian common usage English. So 7 kilometers run, 8.04 per kilometer. So just coming up on the hour, 7:08:56. So this should be just about perfect for my week of training. As I approach the Beaupark ramp, which, as you know, is a TH for me, alright, up I go. I have about 600 meters from the end of my run. Now, as I get the sun right in the face, reflecting off the sweat on my nose. So this is the top of the Beaupark ramp, and where I start jogging again. When I get out of Beaupark, I will check my timing on the recording and see if I have to wrap it up or not. I have been quite conservative on the long sections of recording. I have pressed the pause a few times. I would say I've paused about 8 times during this recording. But that should be okay, as I say. I will try and have a look to see how much I have already to decide when to say goodbye to you. Take a right. See, these arrows are still pointing towards me. So obviously, whoever's out today or yesterday chose to go in the opposite direction, basically, from me today. Last junction of the trails. This part of Beaupark, I either run or hike or e-bike at least 3 or 4 times a week. It is within 1 kilometer of my house, so all my various routes and to funnel in on this section before my final stretch to home. Last hike. I'm going to pause, have a look, and decide what to do then. So I'm pausing the recording now. Well, I'm pretty much bang on target now for 36 minutes. So I will say bye-bye to you now. I can almost see my destination now. It'd be nice to hit 8K when I get there, but we'll see as I cross Cedar Hill Road. Last little push for the finish. I've just heard zone 3, which is good. It means I'm shifting along a fair bit. I've run for 1 hour now. And I have the right amount of minutes for my recording. So, as I approach the end of another stellar week of training, I'll just say adieu, hasta la vista, a la prochaine, and catch up with you again. I just heard the 8 minutes, 2 seconds per kilometer for 8K. So that is what I need. Bye-bye.